Now I'm over on Washmill Court, and I'm looking up at the clear cut over across from Chapters there. And just to orient us, see, this is, they name everything, don't they? This is the IMAX Theater. And here is the infamous Washmill Underpass. Now, this and that are directly connected in that the underpass project was slated to cost $10 million. It wasn't supposed to be completed for 25 years, so there was no rush to do this project because of the federal stimulus project. Peter McKay plucked it from the city's list and made it first for whatever reason. The city had a cost overrun of $8 million on it, so it was an $18 million project. Part of that $8 million, a very small part, about $2 million of it, came from this intersection. The cost of upgrading the lights and putting in the turn lanes. But back to the underpass, the cost overrun, that $8 million, well, how is the city going to pay for that? Ultimately, what they did is they put it in the city's real estate department, and they paid for it through the Bears Lake Expansion Fund, which is that clear cut right there, one I had climbed up just earlier. So you get an underpass improving access to Bears Lake at the cost of 100 plus acres of clear cut and a degraded wilderness behind it. This is how it goes all the time. You can't pay for this kind of sprawl in Bears Lake. You just can't pay for it through property taxes related to Bears Lake. You got to keep expanding and sell off that land, sell off all that land up there, and the sales goes into a fund that goes back and funds the underpass. So, but then what's going to happen when all that land gets developed and you got a bunch of infrastructure up there that doesn't pay for itself? You guessed it. You got to expand again somewhere else, probably back over that way. Anyway, this is sort of case study in how suburban sprawl leads to more suburban sprawl and how the city covers its cost overruns kind of disingenuously by saying that Bears Lake pays for itself. I'll have all this detailed on the Halifax Examiner at halifaxexaminer.ca.